that you, you know, I stole something from him, and I kind of became famous for saying it out here. But you know, that's how you acquire those little sayings out here, is you steal them from other people. Mm-hmm. In case you didn't know it, that's how you get them. And, I like this one so well that I immediately made it mine. You know, and it says, it doesn't matter whether you come from Yale, jail, Park Place, or Park Bench, this program will work for anybody that comes in here and works the program. Anybody. I hate to tell you, but I didn't make that up myself. but it's true. I mean, the program works for everybody, and it doesn't matter how much dope you use. And her book even, you know, later on, I got around to reading the basic text, which I advise any good addict to do, you know, maybe in your fourth or fifth year anyway. You read the basic text, and it'll tell you, you know, it doesn't matter how much you used or who you used with or anything else. It's the fact that you're here and you want to get clean. You don't want to do that anymore. And the way we change from that to a life in recovery, and a life without that is we work the steps. And in the process of working the steps, we're changing who we are. We're changing the way we do things. And you know what? Once I found that out, I found out that I was gradually, little by little, changing a whole lot of stuff about myself. And you know, some of the things that I was changing, I said, you know, this has got to be for the better. This other way wasn't working very good for me. And so I've been doing that, you know, and I decided that if I just keep on doing this, day after day, you know, one day at a time, I'm going to have a life in recovery. I'm going to be living in recovery. You know, and I just in February, I celebrated 24 years clean in this program. You know, for me, that's awesome. You know, you don't have to be impressed. I'm impressed with the shit out of myself. Yeah, I look in the mirror every morning, man. I mean, that's how impressed I am. Now, I'm not that easily impressed either. You know what? If you're new around here, get your sponsor. Keep going to meetings, and stop placing so much emphasis on your uniqueness. Just try to become a better person. You know, and I found that if I try to become a better person, I'll eventually be a better person if I work the steps the way I'm supposed to. This little puppy in here thinks that I'm just it, you know. So my life's ambition, if I could even come remotely close to that goal, is to become half the man that she thinks I am. Just half the man that she thinks I am. Because she just dotes on me, you know. And I can't go to the bathroom without her standing there looking at me. How you doing? and that's cool with me, you know. I'm sorry, baby.
Yes.
But I took her down and bought her a new little outfit. She's got more clothes than I do. Anyway, you know what? Get your sponsor, work the steps, and keep coming to these meetings and work with some newcomers. Once you get a little of this, you know, the best way to keep it is to keep giving it back. If you keep giving it back, you're going to start getting more and more and more of it. So, and it doesn't matter about your uniqueness, whether you use the water out of a toilet or out of the gutter or where you got your water. I mean, we all know that when you cook it, it purifies it anyway, right? That's what I always believed. a good thing. But it's true, you know, it doesn't matter where you come from, Yale, jail, or Park Place, or Park Vance, the program will work the same identical way for everybody that walks in these doors and applies themselves to these.
Here with another one of Tom's friends who came to the ceremony today. What was your name again?
Fred.
Fred, good to meet you, Fred. We were on our way up the hill, and you told me you had met Tom some time ago. And what was that experience like when you first met Tom?
Actually, I first met him through Shannon. I was a friend of Shannon's, and didn't really know him too well. And years later, I was doing pretty bad, and I called my ex-wife, and she called Shannon, and Shannon called Tom, and he knew of me, didn't really even know me, took time out of his day and made special arrangements and got me into a rehab without even knowing really who I was personally. And yeah, I thought that was pretty amazing. You know, it took me quite a while to come full circle and get right. Years later, I seen him back when I was in the rooms, and he had a lot of good qualities about him, and I know NA was something he believed to the bone, and that's something I really admired about him.
Right on, man. Okay, well, we're going to thank you for this brief interview, and I'm glad you had a chance to know Tom. He's a really good guy. I agree with you on that 100%. You have a good one, man. We want to take a few minutes with one of the people that, I mean, really, you know, that just been behind this effort, you know, from the very beginning, you know, and we want to thank you personally, Brandy, for helping out so much with getting all this arranged and taking your time out and doing that. And I know that you got some history with Tom and his family. Tell us about that.
Oh, man. well, let me say this, that as well as everybody else that knew him, I could always expect a good laugh.
Yeah.
And the truth, he never lied to me, never ever lied to me, never misled me. I'd call him like a confidant, and I'd say whatever was struggling me or troubling me, and he'd give me a suggestion. And then he'd watch me go about and do whatever I'd do. And when I didn't follow the suggestion, I'd come back with a bigger problem than I had the first time. You know what? He was a lovable man. Both his sons are very dear and special to me. And I just pray for all of us in our time of loss. And the reality through all the God using me as an instrument to help lay Tom to rest. The reality of it is that everything's happened as God would see it to happen. And I just thank N.A. and his family, and it's been an honor to be a part of helping put closure on his life. So, thank you.
All right, thank you.
I'm glad because of that. I'm just grateful for the part that I did get. I know I was out there pimping and robbing banks and doing a lot of things that I probably shouldn't have been doing. Once I got into recovery, it wasn't exactly at all what I thought it was going to be. I thought that I was going to come in here and just learn how to not use, and that was going to be it. I was going to be okay. It wasn't that at all. You know, this program taught me how to change the way I thought, change the way I lived, change really a lot of the person that I was. I haven't robbed any banks. I haven't robbed any of you guys in a long time. If I still do that, you'd be in deep shit. Because none of your stuff would be safe. You know, your TV, your they got those laptops out there now. I know I'd be stealing lots of those. I don't do any of that anymore. You know, if I do anything at all, I give something to somebody. Because what I found out that is I always seem to get back a hell of a lot more than I give away in recovery. And if you're new around this program, just keep coming back. Because I can't tell you how much better your life is going to be if you'll come in here and you'll do a few little simple things, you'll work the steps, and you work the steps like Lars was telling you. That's what you do, stay clean, is you work the steps, and they change your life, they change the way you think. They've got change written all the way through them. And I used to say this a lot, you know, that it doesn't matter where you come from, whether you come from Yale, jail, Park Place, or Park Beach, this program works the same identical way for everybody that comes in the door. That applies itself to work through the steps. So, that's almost all I have to say.
Almost.
I just wanted to tell you one thing. That was about Tiger Woods. They came out with a new Viagra pill and named it after Tiger Woods. It's called Tiagra. and what's so much better about it is it's good for 18 holes.
Well, you said that. What's good about it is good for 18 holes.
I'm standing up here with Tim, and I know Tim was a good close friend with Tom. I know they used to go out on the weekends to the movies and stuff like that. How you doing today, Tim?
I'm doing good, Lawrence.
Good. Tim, you know, I just wanted to take a moment to ask you. I know, you know, we were all real close to Tom. Tell me some of the highlights that you guys had together.
Well, you know, Lawrence, there was a lot. You know, I met Tom probably about 13 years ago when Tommy was just a little boy. And one thing we had in common is that we were both single parents. And I think probably the most memorable times that I had with Tom were some of the campouts that we used to go to for NA. And we used to just let the boys run around and play, and Tom and I would kick it around the campfire and just count our blessings and thank God we were clean and you know how good things were during the time. And you know, in his later years in life, he got down to where he couldn't make those campouts anymore, and we just kind of settled down and started going to movies on the weekend. And you know, he's like a father to me, and he always will be, and I'm gonna love him and miss him.
Right on, Tim. Thanks, man.
Where did you set a meeting?
To all the people, for all the time that you've been clean and in the program.
Okay.
And what do you want to say to Narcotics Anonymous?
All right. Are you ready now?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Oh, yeah. This is old man Tom. It used to be just old Tom, but now it's old man Tom. And I want to thank all you people for being my friends and being close to me and helping me get through this last 24, 25 years of being clean and getting around NA. I've seen you have grown up in NA, and so has my son. I had a son who grew up in NA, and I grew up in NA. And then I had one son that didn't grow up in NA, and he's doing 50's life. But I want to tell you that I appreciate all you people. And if you get out here and you work the program, you wind up dying like me. No, I'm just kidding. But this is a, I've had a wonderful life and being clean. God, you know, I love all you people, I really do. I know a lot of times I joke and I say, and I say things and if nobody told you they love you today, if nobody told you they love you today, call your sponsor. But really, if nobody told you today, I love you. I love you from the bottom of my heart. And my friend Lawrence there, he's been as much a sponsor as he has a sponsee to me, so. You guys, if you want to come by and see me while I'm still kicking around, or, guys, what if I'm here next year and I'm still hearing the same old thing played back to me? Anyway, I'll see you guys down the road. I'll save a seat for you if you just let me know you're coming.
Joke, they said.
Yeah, well, you know, we're here with Raymond right now, and he's also a member of Narcotics Anonymous and a friend of Tom's. And Raymond, we wanted to ask you, how did you remember Tom?
Well, Tom was very kind and loving, and one thing that I remember from him was a joke. He said that there were these two guys, Fred and Bart, and that they made a pact that whoever died first will come to earth to let the other one know if they have Narcotics Anonymous in heaven. Well, Fred dies, and 1 week later, the windows in his bedroom started to open. They were thunders coming around, and so he started to be afraid. But then he remembered that the pack they had. So he asks, "Is that you, Fred?" And then from the wind, it sounds like he says, "Yes, Bart, that's me, Fred." And so he says, "Well, tell me, what is it? What you got?" And so he says, "Well, Bart, I had good news and bad news." Well, Bart says, "Well, tell me the good news." "Yes, they do have Narcotics Anonymous in heaven." And so, and Bart says, "And what's the bad news?" "Well, you my speaker next Sunday." And so I know Tom is in heaven, and I know Tom is the speaker this Sunday.
Right on, man. Thank you,
Raymond. Thank you so much.
Appreciate that.
Love you, Tom. All right.